I wanted to take a few minutes today to explain the differences between an employee and an independent contractor. I've gotten a lot of questions lately from people I've been trying to help get hired as online teachers about what is that going to look like for me? Am I going to be able to do it? Is it something that I can make a living doing? You can. You can absolutely make a living doing it. And even if you just want to supplement your income. But you may have some questions about what that's going to look like. So if you're not familiar with the differences between the two, just think of it like this. Let's just keep it as simple as we can. An employee generally has all their equipment provided for them, such as computer, office space, chair, email address, printers, anything that you can think of that you would need to facilitate whatever it is that you're doing for the company you're working for is going to be provided, with the exception of, you know, your wardrobe's not provided unless you're given a uniform to wear so that everyone looks similar. Other than that, if it's another job, then they will have a dress code, but they don't provide you with clothing. They will also, on your behalf, they will take out FICA, Social Security, and then they will take out whatever deductions you've asked them to hold back on your behalf. And then at the end of January, they will issue what's called a W-2, and then you take that W-2, and then you file it with the IRS, and that's how you file your taxes, right? You either get a refund from the IRS, or you end up paying taxes depending on what your W-2 says. So with an independent contractor, that's not the case. You can work for more than one company or entity. Your services are your own, and you generally sign a contract with every company that you work, that you contract with. So the terms of your employment will be specified in that contract. Your pay is 100% of whatever services you bill the company that you're working for, unless there is a pre-negotiated fee. I know some, in my case, I'm an online ESL teacher, and there are some platforms that charge a fee for you being on their platform and being able to teach on their platform. That is negotiated ahead of time, and so you're aware of that. Everything else would be sent directly to you, and that's gross pay that you're receiving, either electronically or by a check. But they will send you what's called a 1099. And if you work for several companies, you may receive several 1099s. And then you would take that to your accountant, usually. If you're really good with math, you can probably do your own taxes. But I've never been good at math, so that's not a thing for me. So I usually take mine to my accountant. And then based on whatever taxes I've estimated and prepaid during the year, the accountant will adjust it. So let's talk a little bit about how you're responsible for your own FICA, your Social Security number, and your own deductions, right? So you can estimate what your income is going to be, and you're going to know about how much you're going to make because you are going to have control of your schedule. So you know how many hours you're working every day, you know how many days you're working, and that kind of thing. So it'll be fairly simple for you to estimate how much money you would make. As a matter of fact, that's how some people decide to make the leap from maybe going part-time to maybe going full-time, as they estimate how much money they're going to make. So all of that being said, let's talk about some of the benefits Let's talk about some of the benefits there are to working for yourself. And working, it doesn't have to be from home, but we always say working from home because you're not going into a physical office or a physical classroom or a physical place to go work. You're doing it on location, right? I know some teachers teach from a boat. Some teach from an RV while they're traveling the world. How exciting is that? But that aside, which is really cool, you have time to do the things that you might not necessarily have had time to do before. Maybe hobbies that you always wanted to try, or maybe you had to put some down to go work for someone else. And I don't know, maybe you can pick them back up. It makes you a better organized person, in my opinion. You have the shortest commute you've ever heard of in your life. So if you live in an area like I do, where the traffic is horrendous. It doesn't matter if it's daytime, nighttime, because at nighttime, even though there's no cars on the road, they're doing construction, right? So there's always traffic. So no more traffic to deal with, no more rushing around. And you don't spend as much money on a wardrobe. You don't spend as much money on dry cleaning. You don't spend as much money on gas. So all of those things are things that you should consider when you are maybe looking at changing careers, and maybe this might be for you. I hope that it is, because it will, you will just feel so much better, and it will feel like it's something of your own, and you can take those skills and move forward, upward and onward, as they say. So I hope this video has been good for you. I post new videos every Friday. I would love to hear from you, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.